Welcome back to another part of Turn It Finish Right, Rise from the Ashes. I don't want to record it, but I have to.
Rise from the Ashes.
Are you two all set?
Us? Ashes from Rise.
Hey. What's this? She couldn't be. You're selling lunches here? This is a crime scene. Hello, half and half, was it? Half and half milk? Oh, I know what milk I'd like. Oh, thanks. Yeah, she doesn't have money to. And you, sir? Yes. Some crunchy goodness coming at you. Thanks. Interesting way of doing business. This area is off limits to anyone without clearance. Especially passers by. Who are you, officers? No, but you. You don't exactly look like the type to have clearance. That's hardly a way to greet someone. Even if my days are, as cough up queen are over. Cough up? Huh? You know, I'm feeling kind of full. Maybe I'll pass the lunch. Cookie Mama, I'm quite connected to this case, you see. Images are burning to my eyes, you can see. Yes, all the sordid secrets. Secrets? Dear me, you are a slow one, aren't you? I'm referring to the murder, the stabbing of that detective. Noise. What? What? The witness clearly saw me committing the crime. You're the witness my sister was talking about? Please! Cough up, Queen. Tell us what happened. Cough it up! My name is Angel Star. Don't you go forgetting it. what's your name again? Or before you know it, I'll have you whimpering at my heels. Abuse.
Yeah, Asian knew whipping at her heels since you forgot.
She means it. That's right, she's an abusive woman. I love that sausage she has around her. Well, as on a necklace. Somehow I knew. And, hey, yeah, she has onigiri on the top. I'm hungry. I said it was a day of destiny. I knew something was gonna happen. Just like I know that daily special on Friday. Hey! It's Friday! Every week is salmon. Destiny? Was yesterday special for some reason? You're a defense attorney, right? You should know that. You should know the foul misdeeds of evil ones who haunt this den of inequity. Evil ones. Prosecutors. They have no qualms at all about blackening the name of innocence. And yesterday they paid homage to the most evil one of all. They gave an award for the King of Prosecutors. What a farce. So she's saying there was some sort of prosecutors convention yesterday. I was almost compelled to lace their lunches with something foul. You have a personal grievance against prosecutors or something? Or is there some kind of scientific evidence? Not everything is scientific of this evil youngness.
What's with it overreacting to something like this?
Mock me at your own risk. You'll find out why they call me the cough up queen. She's gonna make you cough up with all that food she's giving you. The most heinous of all the ones, the one that they awarded yesterday. It was in his car that they found the body. Proof that he devours the evilest lunches of all. Okay. Really what? I'm totally confused. One thing's clear, this lunch lady has a thing against prosecutors. Thank you. So now you all was a evil witness, Miss Star. It was a fascinating spectacle, to be sure. Okay. I now feel what they say when they talk about a woman's wrath. What? To see Lana Sky wield that knife so... Her knife flashed in anger, bringing him to a sad end. It was really a sight to see. I mean, you saw the very moment of the crime. The sound of his silvery ties to this world. Cruelly cut still rings in my ears, and the rhythmic beat of Lana Sky's knife. Wait a second, you know Lana Sky? Of course, it's quite a fleet, becoming chief prosecutor. My throat's already destroyed. How many lunchboxes of sin did she pack to make that journey, I wonder? She always travels light. Now why would this pretty lunch lady know the chief prosecutor's name? I don't know, why was I asked? ask you a bit about yourself, Miss Star. I come here every day to sell watches. I import only the freshest and best from the Far East. For some reason, the box lunches are a hit here. Because of those giant reasons. Why not make the lunches here rather than import them? Did you say something? No. Only true connoisseur. Someone has tried General So's trilobite lunch set. Never mind, you win. I don't even want to appreciate part of the trilobite's flavor. Anyway, I come here every day to sell lunches. My boyfriend works in the security room here at the prosecutor's office. My boyfriend. Yeah. See the security room over there? The glasses walled booth? I sell my lunches and I'm here, and since I'm here, I drop in to see him. Selling lunches is more important than romance. So, to scientifically analyze the data available so far, you, Mr. R, are a lunch vendor with an ulterior motive for coming here. Useful analysis. Not.
This is why you don't take notes.
Did you have a bad experience with the prosecutor, Mr. R? I sense some hostility. Hostility? Perhaps. Prosecutors are all alike. The bigger they get, the worse they smell. Kind of a, like, 10-day-old clams in the chowder. I wonder if the star was involved in some sort of legal trouble in the past. That should be a cause of food poisoning, scientifically speaking, of course. I mean, now you're talking, cough up queen. I thought she was just a lunch vendor, but now I'm not so sure. Well, what do we have in our... What do we have in our... Change from your office, really. Thanks. Look, there's a trophy or something here. A trophy, what? What, that shield? It takes real nerve to display stuff like this. Whoever's office this is, he must be a real stuck-up jerk. Mr. Phoenix, right? You never tire of prying into other people's business, do you? That voice. Long time to see you, Edward. Mr. Edgeworth! Of course, I'm his biggest fan. My sister introduced us once, and right, your sister was the chief prosecutor after all. Well, what brings you here? I warn you, I've been known to be a real stuck-up jerk. No, did I? No. This is Mr. Wright here. Hey, don't blame me. We're just here to investigate a murder case. Murder. Body was found in the nasty bright red sports car in the parking lot. That would be my car. What of it, you rich boy? What? Your car? I'll say one thing, she certainly can scream. I'm not screaming because that would waste so much of my energy in my throat. So the body was found in your car? Go ahead, say it, right? You think I did it, don't you? After you went through all that trouble to help me last year, no less. No, we don't think you did it. I mean, it was my sister who stabbed him. She didn't do that. So you're the chief prosecutor's little sister, then? Yes, sir. I'm a Scott. It's nice to meet you again. Now that didn't sound forced at all. You've really grown. It was a surprise to me, too. To think my own car would be the scene of a murder. Can't even drive it now! more surprising still. Now I'm forced to prove my superior's guilt. I can understand. Wait, what did you say? Lana Sky is the chief prosecutor, the top prosecutor in the district. She can't prosecute herself, so I'll be the prosecutor at the trial tomorrow. You? Mr. Edgeworth? Oh, wait, we're screwed. To be honest, it's a bit of a miracle I'm still here at all. I know! Well, I mean, you can't drive your car. What do you mean? Rumors? You heard the rumors about me, haven't you? How's Edgeworth? It's hard to remember a time when there weren't rumors about this guy. Forging evidence or edging false testimonies, illegal searches, you name. Thanks to you, my innocence was established in the trial at the end of last year. However, there was some who say I'm the one responsible for the current incident. What? That's crazy. Some people need very little to excuse to think ill of others. That's a fact of life, impossible to stop. Present me with toys like this. You think it's funny? Toys? That bronze shield? That's not bronze! There's gotta be a story behind that one. Chief Prosecutor Scott, yes, we first worked together on a case 2 years ago. It was my first big case. That's right, I remember. 2 years ago, I wasn't even a lawyer yet. Since then, I always felt that shield looking out for me. It appears I was mistaken. Mistaken? Why? I mean, I know she's not the warmest person, but I'm sure she felt some responsibility for you. Then why? Why did she stab someone in the trunk of my car? I wanted to drive my car! Senpai, why? Not only that, she stabbed him with my knife. What? Gosh. Why? Mr. Edgeworth, your knife was the murder weapon? To be specific, it was a knife kept in the toolbox in the trunk of my car. Of course. Edgeworth? What? Are you sure you didn't do it? Come on, can't you take a joke? You have a strange sense of humor, Mr. Wright. But death is a funny joke! KKK? King of Prosecutors? It's a great honor. They send that shield to the best prosecutor each year. What? So? So that K, that's... K stands for King? Yeah, you got a problem with that? I didn't design the thing. King of Prosecutors? Kinda like Employee of the Month, only better? This year, huh? You can take that foolish grin elsewhere, right? I lost a day of work to receive that travesty. Huh? Why is that? I had to go to the police department ceremony to receive that broken shield. Police department? Yes, right next to the police station downtown. You've been there, correct? Where Detective Rubbish works? Yeah. I'm always wondering something about your shield. Why is it broken? What does it matter? I've got more important things to worry about. I got a job to do. Oh, right. He doesn't seem too concerned about your reward for better or worse. He said it was a busy day at for prosecutor's office. Maybe we should ask him more about yesterday. Alright. Oh my god, we haven't even gotten to the game yet. Or at least the good parts. Could you tell me more about the... About yesterday, the day of the murder? Yesterday was the annual cleaning day at the prosecutor's office. Cleaning day? Working with the police department, we sort of unfollow all evidence for solved cases. We call it evidence transfer. Wiping your hands of old cases, in other words. What or nothing. The ceremony was held at the police department. There's an annual annual review and awards for outstanding police officers and prosecutors. That's what you got from the shield. I was at the police department yesterday afternoon. I got back here at 5:12. That's very precise. People like myself and Mr. Edward pride themselves on our precision, Mr. Wright. No, I place little faith in my memory. The only thing I trust is solid evidence. This is the parking stuff in the underground lot. The murder took place around 5:15. So the murder happened right after you got back. I'd appreciate it if you direct that suspicious glare elsewhere. Yeah, I missed it. Excuse me, but is Mr. Edgeworth anywhere on the premises? I'm Edgeworth. What is it? I'm here, sir, at the request of the chief, sir. I've got your report, sir. Report? What? Did you find new evidence in the case against Chief Prosecutor Sky? I don't like the way this conversation is going at all. Sky, sir? No, sir. No name of that kind. Not in this report, sir. I think I just heard Edgeworth's lid blow. Mr. Edgeworth's lid isn't very on tight. Is on very tight, is it? I made a clear request to the police department. Did I not? I need to focus on the trial tomorrow, so don't bring me anything unrelated. Sir, but sir! I'm just following orders, sir! They told me to bring this to you. I wasn't aware of the particulars of your arrangement, but give me your name. Yes, sir. Meekins, sir. Officer Meekins. Right. Officer Meekins, take your report and leave. And good luck with that raise next month. Ooh, get wrecked. But sir, I didn't know. Poor guy. Looks like he was absent on the day they gave out brains and good luck. Ha! Right. Yes, sir. Yeah, he got me off guard. As you can see, I'm busy. So you may leave now. Let's see what he says, Mr. Wright. The victim was a detective from the same department as a patrolman just now. Go down to the police department. You can ask for more there. Thanks. He seems to have finally calmed down, at least. What? Gumshoe, is that you? Whew, we're finally here. Why would they put the detective so far away from the prosecutor's office? That took almost 30 minutes by taxi. Traffic wasn't even that bad. This is my first time to appear at the police department, actually. Hold on, what's that? What is this? Okay, that's creepy. Disturbing! Why does it undulate like that? Oh, wait, I know. This is the blue badger. Make him a police mascot. Wow, Mr. Wright, you know a lot about the police department. So he does seem familiar somehow. Forget the blue badger. Who's that next to him? One appears to be dancing with the blue badger. Oh, he's noticed me. He sure is running over here fast. Hey, pal! What are you doing here? That's my line, Detective Gumshoe. Specifically, why were you dancing over there? What? Well, at least he doesn't seem to be busy. This is our chance to get information. Hey, I'll have you know I'm very busy, man, pal. Let's see what's going on in his pants. I'll give you one word of advice, pal. You better not agree to defend the suspect in this case. Why not? Huh? Well, it's just that the chief prosecutor has confessed to the crime. She says she summoned the detective to the prosecutor's office, and she killed him. But what if she's not telling the truth? Yes, well, no. Come on, pal. There's plenty of evidence against you. But what if the evidence was faked? Hey, pal. Can I speak to you for a second? Huh? Me? Why is this little girl so peeved at me? She's a relative of the suspect, Lana Sky's sister. Whoa, the chief prosecutor's little sister? Just please investigate this case carefully, okay? Scientifically. Yes, sir. Oh, by the way. You might want to keep your voices down. You don't want to be overheard using words like faked. Huh? It's a sensitive issue with us these days. So what are you doing? Detective? Don't you? Me? Oh well, nothing really. You kicked me out of the criminal affairs. Detective Gumshoe, what did you do this time? What do you mean, this time? What do you mean, this time? Then what happened? I know things are busy right now. I mean, with my sister's case and all. It's true, you've never had a chief prosecutor murder anyone before. Only the highest ranked people are being led into criminal affairs now. The lowest ranking guy. Get the badger dance down, Pat. Isn't there anything else you could be doing? Something useful? Something that can get you money? You're getting paid, like, under minimum wage. Chief of Police himself is directing this investigation, pal. And Officer Marshall was assigned to the underground parking lot. Officer Marshall? Now that I think about it, I did seem to know that Marshall guy. The patrolman in charge of the crime scene. Drop his card a lot. Let's see, Bruce Goodman. Sounds familiar. Nah, my mistake. What? Don't you work together with him in the criminal affairs? Whoa! Now I remember! Bruce Goodman! He's the victim! That's what I thought. Can you tell us more, just hit the gumshoe? Yeah, tell us more. In the next part, because, you know, yeah, see you until then, please.